Hello, this is NanoDano at devdungeon.com, and we're going to walk through the process of creating a custom service file for systemd. In this video, I'll be using Ubuntu, but these instructions should apply to any distribution that is also using systemd. For this tutorial, let's create a bash script that will act as our service. I'll make a file here called pointless.sh. In pointless.sh, I'll add a shebang, create an unending while loop, and inside it, just echo the current time and then sleep for a second. This way, it will run forever the same way a service will. Be sure to add the executable permission to the script with chmod plus x pointless.sh. Now that we have a service that we want systemd to manage, let's create a service file. Go to /etc/systemd/system. Here, create a new file. In this one, we'll name it pointless.service. It's important to end the file with .service. In the pointless.service file, the only section that is technically required is the service section. So let's create that section by typing out service with a capital S inside brackets. In this section, we'll specify some of the options for our service. Probably the most important option is simply the exec start option. Type out exec start equals, and then the name of the command we want to run. In this case, /home/nanodano/pointless.sh. Then let's save this file. Technically, that's really all we need to do. So we can actually try it out by running sudo systemctl start pointless. We can verify that the service is running with sudo systemctl status pointless. We should see a green circle along with the active text to indicate that it's running. It also tells us what the process ID is. After the status information, it will also output a few lines of the most recent log output. By default, the standard output of a service goes to syslog, so we can view the output by manually inspecting /var/log/syslog, or by running sudo journalctl-u pointless. You can also run sudo journalctl-u pointless-f to tail the log and see new entries in real time. Notice the date, hostname, and process ID are prepended to the log message for each line. We can stop our service with sudo systemctl stop pointless. At this point, you know how to create and manage a very simple service. Depending on your use case, this may be all you need, but it's likely you need some more customization, so let's look at some more of the common options. To view the options, open the manual page for systemd.service with man systemd.service. Look for the section labeled options. This lists some options that we can use in our service section of the file. Exec start is there. That's one we already saw. If we look further, there's also an exec start pre and exec start post. We can trigger these scripts to be run before and after the exec start command. There is also exec reload, exec restart, and exec stop. If stopping and reloading requires something more than basic killing and restarting the program, you can have custom scripts to do this. You can also set timeouts for starting and stopping, as well as maximum runtime for the service. If a runtime max sec value is provided, the service will be terminated after that limit is reached. Let's go back to the service file now. There are a few common options that I want to add here. Not all of them are in that help file. First, let's add the restart option. Add restart equals always on a new line in the service section. Let's also add a working directory. So working directory equals /home/nanodano. Let's also specify user equals nanodano and group equals nanodano. These are a few options that most people will find useful. If you need to set environment variables, you can do that with the following format. Environment equals key equals value. For example, if we wanted to set the go path to /home/nanodano/go, we could add environment equals go path equals /home/nanodano/go. You can have multiple lines to define multiple variables, or you can separate them with a space. You can also use an environment file that contains all of the environment information in a file. So far, we've only looked at the service section of our file. Let's create a new section at the top called unit. and provide a description, and then specify after equals network.target. That specifies that the service needs networking to be ready before starting. Our service doesn't truly need networking, but many services are TCPI services, and this is a common option that's needed. Let's also add a section at the bottom named install. The install section is needed if you want to enable the service and have it run automatically on startup. In the install section, add wanted by equals multiuser.target. This tells systemd we want to load this as part of the standard multi-user boot process. Now we can go back to the terminal and run sudo systemctl enable pointless. This will enable the service to run automatically whenever the system reboots. You can disable this by running sudo systemctl disable pointless. If you manually modify a service file, make sure you run sudo systemctl daemon reload. You can also restart the service with sudo systemctl restart pointless. Now, if we check systemctl status pointless, we'll see the description that we added to the file. You can also edit a service file with sudo systemctl edit pointless dash dash full. If you edit this way, you don't need to run daemon reload. You can only do this with existing files though. You can't create new ones with this method. That's all for now. Thank you for watching. Check out devdungeon.com and subscribe to the channel.